Dear students, in the previous video lecture, I discussed how to find average power in AC circuits. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss magnetically coupled circuits. So here we'll discuss mutual inductance, then we'll discuss coefficient of coupling, and then we'll discuss some numerical questions. So first let us see what do you mean by magnetically coupled circuits. Suppose you are having an inductor, you are having a coil, you are applying some voltage, you are applying some alternating voltage, and the current starts flowing through this coil. Now when the current starts flowing through the coil, what will happen? Here a magnetic flux lines will be created in the coil. In the coil, the magnetic flux lines will be created like this. Suppose this is the direction of current, so there will be the magnetic flux lines like this, that means circular flux lines will be created like this. So here I am representing the magnetic flux lines. These are the magnetic flux lines. This will be created. Now what will happen? According to Faraday's law and Lenz's law. Faraday and Lenz's law. Suppose this is the inductance of coil, this is L1. So here what will happen? A voltage will be induced across the coil. Now what about this voltage? If you write this voltage, it will be V1t will be equal to minus L1 into dit upon dt. Minus L1 into di upon dt. This is called inductance and its unit is handy. Now what happens? Now let us see the meaning of magnetic coupling. Now what will happen? You are having one coil. Suppose this is the coil and here magnetic field lines are like this. Magnetic field lines are like this. Current is already flowing. There are magnetic field lines. Now you are having another coil. You are having another coil. It was kept far away from this coil. Now what happens? You are bringing the second coil, the second inductor in contact with this first inductor. So when you are bringing it in contact with first inductors, suppose it has the magnetic flux lines having some radius. Suppose the magnetic flux lines are up to here. Now what will happen? You are bringing this coil. Suppose this coil is not carrying any current. Now what happens? The moment it comes in contact with the magnetic field lines of coil 1. Suppose it is now at this position and here the magnetic field lines of coil 1 is now linking with the coil 2. Magnetic flux lines of the coil 1 are linking with coil 2. So what will happen? You will see that because of this flux lines, a voltage will also be induced in this coil. So when the voltage will be induced in this coil, because this is also carrying magnetic field lines, so again a voltage will be induced in this coil. Now this voltage will be represented with the help of one inductance that is called mutual inductance. That means there will be a mutual inductance between these two coils, and because of that mutual inductance, the voltages are being induced. Now when the coils are coming more closer, then what will happen? The magnetic flux field lines will be more. So if magnetic field lines are more, that means you can say, if you are taking one mutual inductance, that will be the parameter of how the coils are coupled. So the value of mutual inductance will be increasing. And when it is joined together, at that time the mutual inductance will be highest. Clear? So let us see. You are having this coil. Now you are bringing one coil. Towards this one. Now what will happen? There will be position, suppose at this position. When the second coil is coming at this position, now what you see? You see magnetic field lines are linking the second coil also. So because of this, there will be a mutual inductance will be shown in the coil. a mutual inductance will be shown in the coil. Clear? So now because of this mutual inductance, there will be an EMF in the second coil. There will be an EMF in the second coil, and this EMF will be V2, and it will be equal to minus M into di1 upon dt. That means current due to first coil. Because of current due to first coil, a voltage will be induced in the second coil. Clear? Now there is a concept of sense of winding. So what is the meaning of sense of winding? Let us see. Suppose you are having a coil like this one. Now you will see that a dot polarity is given to the coil. A dot polarity is assigned to the coil. What is the meaning? It means that it is showing the sense of winding. It is showing you the sense of winding since the way the winding has been constructed. So you will see that you will having another coil. Here you see current is entering through this terminal, and here dot polarity is here. That means you see in the first coil current is entering at dot terminal, and second coil you can say the current is leaving at the dot terminal. First coil current is entering in the dot terminal, second coil the current is leaving at the dot terminal. What is the meaning of this? It means here the direction of EMF will be this one. This will be positive, this will be negative, and here the direction of EMF will be this one, positive, negative. That means if the sense of winding of the coil is changed, then the direction of EMF will be reversed. So this is called the sense of winding, and it is shown by dot polarity. Clear? So let us see. We are having a coil. This inductance is L1, this is L2, this is dot, this is dot. Now this voltage source is supplying VS1, this is supplying a current I1t, this is supplying a current I2t. Clear? This is VS2. So now what will happen? The dots are shown, and suppose there is a mutual inductance between these two coils exist. The mutual inductance is M. The mutual inductance is capital M. Its unit will also be Henry or milli Henry. Now what you have to write? You have to write the expression for voltage that has been developed across this one. That means V1t. Here you have to write plus minus V2t. Clear? So let us see how to write V1t and V2t. So first write V1t. So what will be the equation for V1t? You know V1t will be equal to, now I am forgetting the sign, that means the sign of Lenz's law. So from now we will write V equal to L into di by dt instead of writing minus L into di by dt. So I am writing V1t will be equal to L1 into di1t upon dt plus. Now what will happen? You will see that there is a mutual inductance. That means there is current flowing in the second coil also. So because of this current I2, there will be the flux linkage in the primary coil. So because of this current I2 and because of this mutual flux, there will be another EMF. Now what will be the value of this EMF? Clear? This EMF, its magnitude will be nothing but M into di2t upon dt plus M into di2t upon dt. Now here I have written plus sign. So let us check whether it is correct or not. Here you see current is entering through the dot terminal. Here also current is entering through the dot terminal. That means if the current is entering through the dot terminals in both the coil, then there flux will be additive. Here I am writing, if current entering or leaving the dot together, leaving the dot together, then flux is additive. Clear? And there will be the second case. Second case is if current is entering through the dot in one coil, and leaving the dot in another coil, then what will happen? Here it will be subtractive. Clear? Must remember these two points. So here it will be plus. Similarly, let us write for V2T. So what will you write for V2T? V2T will be equal to C. Here for V2T, here it will be L2 into DI2 upon DT. L2 into DI2T upon DT plus M into DI1T upon DT. Because there will be the flux linkage due to the first coil, that means the current I1. So here I am written M into DI1 by DT. Here also it will be positive. So we can also write like this, M into DI1T upon DT plus L2 into DI2T upon DT. Clear? So now if we write this equation in matrix form, then in matrix form you can write, here it you will have V1T and V2T, and you will have two matrices. This will be L1M. Similarly, M, L2. Now you will have DI1T upon DT, and you will have DI2T upon DT. Clear? Now if the polarities have been changed, suppose the polarity is indicated here. So when the polarity will be indicated here, then M will become minus M. So in that case, you will have to write minus M. So if polarities are same, then plus. Polarities are opposite, then minus. So you will see this beautiful matrix equation in the books. So this is very simple. You have to understand. Simply you have to relate the equations of voltages, and you can easily write this equation of matrix, this equation in matrix form. Clear? Now what happens? Now suppose instead of writing DI1T or DT, you can also write in Laplace domain. You can also write this equation in Laplace domain. So if you are writing in Laplace domain, then what will happen? You write its Laplace transformation will be how much? It will be S into L1 into I1T, I1S plus M into S into I2S. So in Laplace domain, you will see it is written SL1, SM, SM, SL2. Here it will be simply I1S and I2S. Similarly, if you replace S by J omega, then you will see it is written J omega L1, J omega M, J omega M, and here J omega L2, and here it will be I1 J omega, here it will be I2 J omega. So this is the matrix, this is the equation. Clear? Next, let us see if two inductances are given in series. Suppose we are having two coils connected in series. If two coils are connected in series, suppose this is first coil, this is second coil, L1, L2. This is given like this. Now what you have to write? You have to write the equivalent inductance. If you have to write equivalent inductance, So how will you write equivalent inductance? You'll have to write the first, you'll have to write the effective inductance of first coil, effective inductance of second coil. So if you write, then you write L1 effective, it will be equal to L1. Next you have to check for the mutual inductance. So there is mutual coupling. Now you'll have to show a direction of current. Suppose current is entering through this terminal. So here you see current is entering through the dot terminal. Here also current is entering through the dot terminal. That means here the mutual inductance will also be added into this inductance. So here it will be L1 plus M. Similarly, you write L2 effective, it will be L2 plus M. L2 plus M. So if you write L equivalent, so it will be L1 plus L2 plus 2M. L1 plus L2 plus 2M. Now you are having the coils like this. This is L1, this is L2. Here the dot, see the dot assigned at the coils. Now if you write L1 effective, then it will be L1. Now what do you see? If a current flows through this coil, then you see here current is entering the dot terminal and here current is leaving the dot terminal. Current is entering the dot terminal, here the current is leaving the dot terminal. That means here it will be minus M. Similarly for L2 effective, again it will be same, it will be L2 minus M. So if you write L equivalent, here the L equivalent value will be L1 plus L2 minus 2M. L1 plus L2 minus 2M. Clear? Now let us see the coils in parallel. If two coils are connected in parallel, then we will write the formula for equivalent inductance. Coils in parallel. Let us assume two coils are connected in parallel like this. L1, this is L2. Here dot is assigned, it is M. Here it is IT, current is entering. Now if you write, what do you see here? Here you see the current is entering the dot terminal, dot in first coil, current is entering the dot in second coil. That means here you can see that here the inductance will be mutual inductance, fluxes are additive. So if the fluxes are additive, then the value of L equivalent, I am directly writing the value of L equivalent, here it will be L1 L2 minus M square divided by L1 plus L2 minus 2A. L1 L2 minus M square divided by L1 plus L2 minus 2M. This is for additive. This is for additive. That means both the coils are having same sense of winding. Clear? Now if you are having the coil like this one, IT dot, here is another dot, this is M, this is L1, this is L2. So here what do you see? Current is entering the dot, here current is leaving the dot, here the current is leaving the dot. So here L equivalent will be L1 L2 minus M square divided by L1 plus L2 plus 2M. See the differences. Numerator is same, that is L1 L2 minus M square. But there is change in denominator. Here it is L1 plus L2 minus 2M. Here it is L1 plus L2 plus 2M. So when it is additive, then L equivalent should be more. So more means what? Here it is denominator minus 2M. That means denominator is less. This part is less, so this is more. Here what do you see? When this is subtractive, you are writing plus 2m. So here it will be L equivalent will be less. Here the value of L equivalent will be less. Clear? So let us solve one numerical on this topic, how to find L equivalent. So let us take you are having three coils connected like this. you are having three coils connected like this, 3 henry, 4 henry, this is 5 henry. Dots are shown like this one. Now you see here the inductance is, mutual inductance is 1 henry, here they have given 2 henry and here they have given 3 henry. So, 3 different inductors are given. You have to find L equivalent. So, let us see how to find L equivalent. First, you will have to check for dots. For that, a current is flowing in the circuit. So, you see this is L1, this is L1, this is L2. This is L3. So what will you write? We'll write L1 effective, L2 effective, and you write L3 effective. So if you write L1 effective, so you see L1 effective will be what? Here the value of L1 is 3 henry. So here it is 3. Now here you see this coil is magnetically coupled with two coils. This coil is magnetically coupled with two coils, one another. So this is having mutual inductance 1 henry. And what do you see? Here current is entering, here current is leaving. So here what will you write? You write minus 1. Clear? Or for your, just to clear your doubt, you can also write here also you write minus 1. Here also I am writing minus 1 so that I can directly write the different coils. Here you see coil is entering through dot and here it is leaving through dot, so here also it will be minus 3. Clear? So what will you write? 3 here it will be 3 minus 1 3 minus 1 and here you see 3 minus 1, here it will be minus 3. 3 minus 1 minus 3 minus 1, let us take here it 6 henry, because in the question it was given 4, it was given 5 and it was given 6, 4, 5, 6 and 1, 2, 3. So here it will be 4 minus 1 minus 3, so here it is 0 henry. Similarly for L2 effective, this is 5 henry, now with this coil it is minus 1. With this coil, here current is leaving the dot, here also current is leaving the dot, so here it will be plus 2, that means 6 henry. Clear? For L3 effective, here it is 6, now here it will be plus 2, for this it will be minus 3, so 6 plus 2 minus 3, so it will be 5 henry. So if you write L equivalent will be sum of these three inductors. So here it will be 0 plus 6 plus 5, it will be equal to 11 henry. So 11 henry will be the answer. 11 henry will be your answer. Clear? So you can see how easily you can solve the magnetically coupled circuits. Next let us see. Coefficient of mutual coupling. Let us see the coefficient of mutual coupling. So how to see the coefficient of mutual coupling, and here we will see the what is the meaning of coefficient of mutual coupling, that is what is the significance of coefficient of mutual coupling, because everywhere you see the formula is clearly written, but we have to see what it is telling. So see that what is the meaning of coefficient of mutual coupling. Here you will see that M is equal to K under root L1 into L2, and from here you will see K is equal to M divided by under root L1 into L2. So this is nothing but coefficient of mutual coupling. This is nothing but coefficient of mutual coupling. this is the coefficient of mutual coupling. So if this is the coefficient of mutual coupling, then let us see the significance of mutual coupling. What is the meaning of this? Its values ranges between 0 and 1. Its value ranges between 0 and 1. So what is the meaning of coefficient of mutual coupling? See here, m is equal to k under root L1 into L2. So here you see, if k is more, then m will be more. If k is less, then m will be less. So if m is less, what is the meaning of? If m is less, that means the coils are kept away with each other. Now if m is more, that means coils are tightly coupled. If m is more, then coils are tightly coupled. That means if the value of k is less, then coils are not tightly coupled, and if k is more, then coils are more tightly coupled. That means it signifies that mutual coefficient of mutual coupling, it signifies how tightly the coils are coupled. And its values lie between 0 and 1. If k equal to 0, then m equal to 0, that means coils are not coupled at all. Clear? And if k equal to 1, that means it is tightly coupled. Clear? So this is coefficient of mutual coupling. Now let us solve some numerical questions asked in previous year GATE examinations on this topic. So let's start with first question. Question 1, it was asked in GATE 2002 Electrical Engineering. You are having a capacitor, resistor, inductor. This is plus minus VT, current is IT. This is minus J12, this is 10 ohm, this is J8, this is also J8. And here one dot polarity is given and another dot polarity is not given. Here dot polarity is given, here the dot polarity is not given, and they are saying this coil is PQ coil, this is P terminal, this is Q terminal. They are saying that it is found that IT and VT are in phase. IT and VT are in phase. What they are asking, what they want to know, these two currents are in phase, then K and dot polarity at coil PQR, then the value of K, then you have to find the value of K, that means coefficient of mutual coupling, and also check whether the dot polarity is at P or Q. You have to check, you don't know whether dot polarity is given. You have to check the value of K, you have to find the value of K, and then you have to check about dot polarity, whether it is at P or it is at Q. So let us see how to find. Clear? From the question it is given, IT and VT are in phase. IT and VT are in phase, what do you mean? That means the phase difference is 0 degree. Phase difference is 0 degree, it means the whole circuit is behaving like a resistor. If the whole circuit is behaving like a resistor, so you are having the resistor of value 10 ohm, then the sum of all these values should be equal to 0. These inductors and capacitors should cancel each other. So let us assume the equivalent inductance is L equivalent. Of these two coils, the equivalent inductance is L equivalent. So what will you write? So from here you will write L equivalent minus J12, L equivalent minus J12, JL equivalent minus J12 should be equal to how much? It should be equal to 0. It should be equal to 0 because there should not be any imaginary term. That means L equivalent should be equal to how much? 12. Now how to write here the formula for L equivalent? You know L1 plus L2 plus minus 2M is equal to 12. So L1 is how much? 8 plus 8. 8 plus 8 plus minus 2M is 12. That means 16 plus minus 2m is equal to 12. Now from here you have to check whether it should be positive or negative. So since there is some quantity that must be subtracted from 16, then it will be equal to 12. So here m will be how much? M should be here the coefficient should be negative. Here it should be negative, then only it is possible. So here you can write 2m is equal to 4. That means m is equal to 2m is equal to 4. That means m is equal to 2. M is equal to 2. So if m is equal to 2, then you will write coefficient of mutual coupling m divided by under root L1 L2, 2 divided by under root 8 into 8. So it will be equal to 0.25. So value of k is coming 0.25. Now we have to check the sign of dot, whether the dot will be at P or dot will be at Q. So what do you see? You see that here the nature of mutual inductance is subtractive. Subtractive means here the current is entering the dot, then here the current should leave the dot. Here the current should leave the dot, then only M will be negative. So here what you see? Dot at Q. So dot will be at Q. Dot will be at Q. So this is the correct answer of this question. Now I am making only one change in this question and you have to write the answer. Suppose now I am saying IT and VT. Here now I am saying IT lags behind VT by 45 degree. Now in the second question I am giving IT lags behind VT by 45 degree. Now the current IT is in lagging in nature. IT and VT the phase difference is 45 degree. IT lags behind VT by 45 degree. Then you have to find M and sense of winding. That means the dot will be at P or Q. So let us see how to solve this question. The angle should be 45 degree lagging. It means what? It means the circuit should be like this. You will have a resistor, you will have capacitor. Resistor value is fixed 10 ohm. So here it should be J10 plus J10. So that here it will be VT, here it will be IT. So from here you can see the angle is 45 degree. So there will be the phase difference of 45 degree between current and voltage. You must observe one more thing, that in the question if they are given IT is leading VT by 45 degree, then here the capacitor should be like RC circuit. Here the capacitor should be like RC circuit, that means here it should be minus J10. Clear? So the way they are asking you the question, you will have to write the answer. Because in gate examination, they will change the previous year questions like this. Once they have asked for 0 degree, they might ask you for 45 degree, they might ask you for 90 degree or 30 degree or 60 degree. So let us see how to solve for 45 degree. So for what should be? Here L equivalent should be J10. Here the value of L equivalent. Here the value of L equivalent should be J10. So what will you write? JL equivalent should be equal to J10. That means JL equivalent or L equivalent should be equal to 10. So L equivalent is how much? L1 plus L2. That means 16 plus minus 2m equal to 10. 16 plus minus 2m equal to 10. 16 plus minus 2m equal to 10. So from here, what will you do? From here, you will write. From here, you will write. Here it is 10 ohm. So this whole term should be equal to 10 ohm. So 16 plus 2m should be equal to 10. So from here, what should be the value of m? Here, what should be the value of m? So from here, m should be equal to, you see, again here it will be, it is coming, if it is coming 10, then what is the meaning of this? It is coming 10, that means it is possible only if m is negative. So m is negative means here you'll have to write minus 2m, and hence from here you can write m is equal to 3. Clear? M is equal to 3. And what about polarity? Polarity dot will again be put at Q because it is coming negative. So K is equal to 3 divided by 8. K will be equal to 3 divided by 8. So by this way you have to make different changes in the question. So I am giving you one task. Suppose here the current IT leads VT by 30 degree. I am giving you a task. IT lags VT by 30 degree. Then find K and dot polarity. Clear? So you have to write the answer in comment box for IT lags VT by 30 degree. Clear? So let us solve another question. Second question, it was asked in gate 98, this is third question, asked in gate 98, plus minus Vs, two ohm, minus J1 ohm, here it is J3 ohm. Here it is 2 ohm, here it is minus J2, here it is dot, here it is J3 ohm, here it is J3 ohm, clear? So here it is, current is given I1, this current is given I2, this current is given I2. You have to find impedance seen from Vs, So this type of circuit is given to you. Let us see how to solve this type of circuit. Very important problem this is. And this was asked in subjective question for 5 marks in gate 1998. So let us see how to solve. What we'll have to do? We'll have to write the equations. If these two coils are given, then what will you do? You can write the equations for voltage and current. So apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in first. If you are applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, this current is I1. So you can write Vs will be equal to, this Vs will be equal to 2 minus J1 into I1. Here I can also write I1 J omega, because if you are writing here in terms of J omega, so here also you will have to write in terms of J omega. But here you can understand I am simply writing I1. Clear? Plus. Yes, and dot polarity is given like this one. This is the dot polarity. This is the dot polarity. This is the dot polarity. So now 2 minus J1 into I1 plus this inductor J3 into I1. Now you see there is mutual coupling. And they have given some value of mutual coupling. Let me check the value. You try to solve the question. you try to solve the question. I am checking the value actually even missing in this question. Yes, here it is minus J1 ohm. Here it is. Here it is minus J1 ohm. Here it is minus J1 ohm. Clear? Here it is minus J1 ohm. Now we have to solve this question. Clear? So let us see how to solve this question. See, here it is minus J1 ohm. So what do you know? You know here it will be current is leaving the dot terminal, and here also current is leaving the dot terminal. Current is leaving the dot, here also current is leaving the dot. If at the both place current is leaving the dot, so here it will be plus M into I2, plus M into I2. So plus, instead of M, what will you write? Minus J1 into I2 will be equal to 0. So from here what will be, or it is already written as Vs. So from here what do you write? You write Vs is equal to 2 minus J1 plus J3, that means 2 plus J2 into I1 minus J1 into I2. This is equation 1. Come to second part, that means in this circuit. So in this circuit if you are applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, so what will you write? You write J3 into I2, J3 into I2. Now here you will have to write the EMF due to first coil, that is current I1. So here it will be again, polarities are additive, so here it will be minus J1 into I1 plus 2 minus J2 into I2 will be equal to 0. So from here what do you see? You see here minus J1 into I1, minus J1 into I1 plus 2 plus J1 into I2 will be equal to 0. So from here what you write? You can write I2 will be equal to J1 divided by 2 plus J1 into I1. J1 divided by 2 plus J1 into I1. So you write I2 is equal to J1 divided by 2 plus J1 into I1. So what will you write? J1 into 2 minus J1, you have to simplify, divided by 2 square plus 1 square into I1. So from here what do you write? J1, that will become 1 plus J2, 1 plus J2 divided by 5 into I1. This is I2. 1 plus J2 divided by 5 into I1. Clear? Next, what will you write? Next, you have to put this I2 in equation 1. Because you have to write the relation between Vs and I1. So here you write Vs will be equal to 2 plus J2 into I1 minus J1 into 1 plus J2 divided by 5 into I1. That means from here it is coming 2 plus J2 into I1 minus, here it is minus, or here it is plus. Now this whole term will be multiplied here. So if these terms are being multiplied here, so here it is minus J1 plus 2 divided by 5 into I1. So from here you write 2 plus 2 by 5, that means 2.4 plus here it is plus 1.8 into I1. So from here what do you write? Z will be equal to Vs by I1. So it is coming 2.4 plus J 1.8 ohm. So this is the answer of this question. This is the answer of this question. Clear? So let us discuss one more problem asked in GATE 2001 on the same topic. Fourth question asked in GATE 2001. It is given that plus minus, here it is R, here it is C, here it is L1, here it is dot, now here it is L2. Here it is L2 and this is mutual inductance M. It is given that R is equal to 10 ohm, C is equal to 3 microfarad, L1 is equal to 40 milli henry, then L2 is equal to 10 milli henry, then you are having M equal to 10 milli henry. Clear? So you are having the values given. You have to find resonant frequency omega naught and you have to find quality factor Q. Resonant frequency omega n and quality factor Q. So you have to find out these two things. So let us see how to find these two things. Clear? This is RC L1 L2. Clear? So what do you see? You will have to write R and C is already given. You have to write L equivalent. L equivalent. If you write L equivalent, it will be equal to L1 plus L2. Now we have to check whether it will be plus 2M or minus 2M. So what do you see? Current direction is not given. So current will enter here and it will leave the dot through this point. That means here you will see that the direction is not given, so current will leave the dot at this point. It means what? Current is entering through the dot, here current is leaving through the dot. So here it will be minus 2m, here it will be minus 2m. So here it is minus 2m. So write L1. L1 is equal to 40 millihenry plus 10 millihenry L2 minus 2m, that means 20 millihenry. So here it will be 30 millihenry. This is the value of L equivalent or simply L. So if L is 30 millihenry, then you will write resonant frequency. This is series RLC circuit. So resonant frequency will be equal to 1 upon under root LC. So from here 1 upon under root L. L is 30 into 10 to the power minus 3 into C. The value of capacitor is 3 microfarad into 3 into 10 to the power minus 6. 3 into 10 to the power minus 6. So from here you are getting 1 divided by under root 9 into 10 to the power minus 8. So from here 10 to the power 4 divided by 3 radian per second. This is the value of frequency omega naught. So once you got the value of frequency omega naught, if you have to find quality factor Q naught, so here it will be omega naught L by R. So from here it will be 10 to the power 4 by 3 into L. L, the value of L is 30 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by R. R is 10. So from here its value will be, from here its value will be 3, here it will be 10, 10 will be cancelled out, from here its value will be 10, from here its value will be 10, clear? So this is the solution of this question that was asked in GATE 2001 and that was also for 5 marks, that was the subjective question asked in GATE examination. So you can see that how easily you can solve the questions asked on the topic magnetically coupled circuit. Clear? So in the next video lecture, I'll discuss about 3 phase AC circuits.